It's been a really long time since I've uploaded any videos about the Philippines. I've mainly been uploading videos about martial arts and my martial arts teaching, as I'm a martial arts instructor, so I'm trying to get my name out and get some more students. Some of you might know this, but when I first started my channel around 2007, I was uploading a lot of videos about the Philippines because I was really interested in the culture and the people and wanting to go there one day to do missionary work. And I was in the Filipino club in my university at the time. I went to the Philippines in 2009, and some people saw some of my videos. I still have them uploaded. My old channel disappeared somehow, and I had to remake a new channel around 2008, I believe. And now, I have not been to the Philippines since 2009, and I want to go back one day, if I ever get the money. I think it's time I upload another video about the Philippines, since it's been such a long time, and I'm sure some of my subscribers would like that. I know a lot of Filipinos subscribe to me because I used to upload videos and I uploaded footage from 2009 when I went to the Philippines. And so hopefully this will make you guys kind of happy or something. Five things I'd like to do if I ever go back to the Philippines. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima. Isa, I would like to practice Filipino martial arts. When I went in 2009, I did some martial arts, and most of it was karate by a group called Tough Guys Philippines. It was a Christian ministry that does karate and self-defense type stuff. And it was pretty fun. And I did get to spend one day at a place, a gym called Yaoyan Puhawi, which teaches Yaoyan, Filipino kickboxing style. And it was really fun. And also, if I go to the Philippines, I want to do Arnis or Kali Eskrima. And there's one group called Rapido Realismo Cali that I've been watching online, and I'd like to go to Luneta Park and train with them and see if I can get up in ranks and things like that. That's the kind of martial arts that I did not get to do when I was in the Philippines, but I did get to buy some Eskrima sticks and take them home with me. I should have bought a bunch more. Delawa, I'd like to try more ethnic foods and explore more of the traditional cultures. There's so many, and try a dish from various groups. Including, I guess, not just high-class food, but what you'd consider low-class food. When I was in the Philippines, I did have some maids and a houseboy cook some kind of dish, and they let me help them make it because I kind of wanted to try it to cook or something. And they put chicken heads inside this kind of bowl or something, or pan, they pot, and there was like some kind of green leafy bean things. And I don't remember what culture it was from, but it was really good. I'd like to go try more different ethnic cultural foods and not just try, you know, Burger Machine and Jollibee. I mean, that was fun. I did get to go to both of those places. And let me tell you, Burger Machine is really good. And it's cool because you can go up on the street and just have a guy make you a hamburger on the street. And the guy will talk to you. And it's kind of like he's a bartender, but he's a burger tender. And it was really fun. And then you can buy hamburgers for street kids and things like that. So I'd like to try more ethnic foods and remember them. And I also would like to learn how to make sinigang, because sinigang is probably my favorite kind of soup in the whole world. It is really good, and it's so hot in the Philippines, they eat really hot soup and you get hot and sweaty. But I'm thinking about taking it to America when it gets really cold in the winter. That's the kind of soup I'd like to eat to get warmed up. Tatlo, I would like to dance tinikling in the Philippines. I was able to do tinikling dancing in California, in Los Angeles area, and I think I'm pretty good at it for a typical guy. I'm not like a master or anything, but it's really fun, and it's skillful, and I really enjoy doing it, and I'd like a chance to do it in the Philippines and find some people who have the poles and go a couple rounds in there for a little bit. It's a really good cardio workout, too. Anim, or is it apat? Yeah, apat. I would like to have an excuse to wear my barong, maybe at a party or some social event. I haven't had a chance to wear it since I bought it in SM Shoe Mart. I think it's called SM Shoe Mart, but they sell all kinds of stuff. And I would like to have an excuse to wear it, and I haven't really worn it in the USA, but I've worn barongs before, but not the one I bought. And I'd like to try to wear it in the Philippines at some cool event, and I think it'd be really fun. Lima, I would like to find someone who actually knows how to teach a language, that doesn't just know another language and tells you random words to memorize, but someone who knows how to teach Tagalog so I can practice speaking Tagalog in the Philippines and maybe actually learn how to speak a second language. I have a lot of trouble finding anyone helping me learn another language. I tried Pimsleur, the CDs, and it was okay for a little bit, but it's pretty boring. And I don't have enough money to buy Rosetta Stone, but I've heard that it's kind of a ripoff anyway. I don't even know. But I'd like to have someone who knows how to teach a language and can do baby steps with me and let me speak Tagalog and learn the grammar so I can learn how to say past tense, future tense, and present tense things so I can actually communicate and have a conversation with some people in Tagalog. That'd be really fun. That's about it. Five things I'd like to do in the Philippines. Also, if there's any Filipinos in the USA or you live in Alabama, and I've never seen very many Filipinos here, if you want to hang out or something, that'd be awesome. All right, especially if you're girls. Just joking. Anyway, whatever. See ya.